Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you from a new location. Been busy moving the last few days. Praise the Lord. Got into a place for the same amount I was spending up there. The last place, I got a place with a separate bedroom now. Rented for the same price. And so praise the Lord for that, for his blessings, brothers and sisters. And I just wanted to give you a little word that the Lord gave me tonight. From 1 John chapter 2, verse 18. And this is a word that the Lord gave me for you, brothers and sisters. Little children, it is the last time, or the last hour. The word there is really hour. It's the last hour. And as we have heard that the Antichrist shall come, even now there are many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last hour. Brothers and sisters, that is a word from the Lord. In the first part of that verse, little children, it is the last hour. It's the last time, brothers and sisters. We're out of here. We are out of here. The Lord is separating and moving and changing, even in that text. The next, let me just read the three verses that the Lord gave me. And then the verse 18 I just read was for you guys, specifically quickened in the text, even though the whole thing is, every Bible verse is relevant. Verse 17, and the world passeth away and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Little children, it is the last hour, or last time, as we have heard that the Antichrist shall come, even now there are many Antichrists, whereby we know that we are in the last time. They went out from us, but they were not of us, for if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us, but they went out that they might be made manifest. They are not all of us. But ye have an unction from the Holy Spirit, and ye know all things. Goes on and on, brothers and sisters. The Word of God is awesome. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I've got more videos to make. I want to just cut this one off as the Lord, you know, make other ones. The Word from the Lord to focus on, brothers and sisters, the quickening, is little children, this is the last hour. Little children, this is the last hours. Look, if you faint not, don't faint. You will reap a regret. The Bible says, and it's just coming to me from the Lord, you know, you will reap if you faint not. Don't faint, brothers and sisters. The reaping time is almost here. It's almost time to go home, brothers and sisters, for the church. You know, the Lord, I will just tell you what the Lord had shown me tonight for myself. The Lord showed me a new horse. He was giving me a new horse, a fresh horse. Of course, a horse, or if the Lord, if you have a dream or a vision and you see like a big old boat or a car or a horse or a bicycle or a motorcycle, something like that, it represents ministry. And if you have a boat that goes fast, it's like a fast ministry. If you had a boat that was on calm water, it means that, you know, this looks, you know, you notice in your dream, the focus is that the water's so calm. That's a calm ministry. If you notice the water's choppy, you know, you have difficulties in the ministry. As an example, brothers and sisters, I just throw these things out there for those who need to hear these things. But the Lord gave me a fresh, fast horse, Lord, brothers and sisters, and he showed me that he gave me this torch to carry forward that was just everywhere I went, the fire was coming off that torch and setting everything on fire, brothers and sisters. And it's, the Lord just reminded me, brothers and sisters, just like Paul Revere, who said the red coats are coming, the red coats are coming. In this case, the red coats is the devil's people. And the Lord even reminded me, those of you who remember from school, I know nowadays they don't teach it in school anymore, but when I went to school, they taught us if it's one if by land and two if by sea. See, but the Lord is, in the Word of God, that's reverse. The first beast comes by land, or I'm sorry, yeah, the second beast comes by land, and the first beast comes by water. So one if by land and two if by sea, you know, it's the opposite of that. Brothers, you know, with Paul Revere. But for the Word of God, the second beast comes by the water, and the first beast comes, I'm getting it backwards again, the Antichrist, the first beast, comes by the water. In the Bible, brothers and sisters, water represents the Goyim, the Gentile nations. So the Antichrist, according to the vision of John, the Revelator, the Apostle John, in Revelation chapter 13, 12 and 13, we see that the Antichrist will rise up from the Sea of Nations. Okay, and then it says the second beast is also called the false prophet in the book of Revelation. He comes from the land. And the Bible interpretation, the land means Israel, the Holy Land. He comes from Israel, brothers and sisters, not from Rome, not from Rome, but from Israel. So if, suppose that someone who was of Jewish blood who became the Pope, that's an example of someone who could possibly be the Antichrist at the same time be in Rome, but came from the Holy Land. Amen. So that's what the Bible tells us, brothers and sisters, and we must go with what the Bible tells us. The Antichrist will come from the Sea of Nations, from the sea, and the second beast, the false prophet, will come from Israel, according to the Word of God in the book of Revelation, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, I didn't want to get into all this theology stuff because I just want to give you the words of the Lord. And it's just so sad there's so much misinformation. And that's part of the end times, brothers and sisters. People trying to, make all these interpretations that's not line up with the Word of God, brothers and sisters. That's why I'm on here. Because the Word of God interprets itself. We yield to the interpretation of the Word of God. It's not subject to any private interpretation, the Bible says. You know, the Bible came to us by the holy men of God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit of God. And the Bible interprets itself. And when the Bible is spoken literally, it's to be taken literally. The rapture is a literal event. There's always somebody who's new. There's always someone who's a copy and a paster from the internet, and they've seen this stuff. Those old cliches that the word rapture is not in the Bible. The word Bible's not in the Bible. The word Trinity's not in the Bible. There's lots of things that are not in the Bible, but we know that they are doctrines. But brothers and sisters, the word rapture is only the Latin equivalent to the word to be snatched up or caught up. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17. And brothers and sisters, we are almost out of here. We are almost out of here. Little children, this is the last hour. And so as Paul Revere, brothers and sisters, I thank my Lord and my God, all of you need to do that. All Christians, all true born again Christians need to do it. That's the ministry. That the Lord would, I pray right now in the name of Jesus, that the Lord himself, before he descends from heaven with a shout, that we would, finish the race that he set before us. That he would renew your strength and renew my strength. And that's what the Lord's doing. He's renewing our strength with a fresh horse. You know, just like the Pony Express, they changed horses every 10 miles so they could hurry up and deliver the mail. It's like Paul Revere. He went forth, one by land and two by sea. He waited for that signal. And then he went forth. And he cried, the red coats are coming, the red coats are coming, the red coats are coming. And brothers and sisters, that's the message that we need to give to the world. The Antichrist and the false prophet are coming. They're on the way. It's time to go. It's time to take up our arms, which is the sword of the Spirit. It's time to take up our arms, which is the shield of faith. It's time to take up our arms, the breastplate of righteousness. It's time to take up our arms, the helmet of salvation. It's time to take up our arms, to have our feet shod with the preparation to give the good news of Jesus Christ, to defend and declare the hope that lies within us. Brothers and sisters, it's time to take up arms and put on the belt of truth. Brothers and sisters, the world needs to see at this last hour, at this last moment, that Jesus Christ is still on the throne. And that his church is a shining example to the world. Brothers and sisters, the hour is late, the world is dark, summer is gone, and winter is nigh at hand, and we are not saved. And the Lord is speaking to me right now, suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not. All of you people who do YouTube videos, and those of you who try to do some evangelizing in your workplace, the Lord is telling you, suffer the little children, all those lost people, to come unto him and forbid them not. Don't try to forbid or block anyone from coming in. Come as you are, even as the song says. You know, just as I am without one plea. Remember that song? You don't know that song, Just As I Am, the altar call song? The blood of the Lord, God was shed for me. Hallelujah, Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, without one plea. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus was shed for me. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name, just as I am. Come to the cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise His name. Jesus has room at the cross for you and me. Hallelujah. He's the way. Hallelujah. I got another video to make about Jesus being the way. I got to get to it. Brothers and sisters, that's the word of the Lord. You know, I have lots of people who want a 30-second video, and then I'll make a 30-minute video, and I give an utterance from the Lord in the middle of that video, and they'll message me and say, where's the word about the rapture in the video? The rapture is imminent. That's not new news. But the instructions and the preparation and the wisdom of God is what people need to be discipled. To be discipled. Because my Bible says in Psalm 24, God asks the question, who will ascend to the mountain of God? Only he who has clean hands and a pure heart. Brothers and sisters, little children, it is the last hour. It is the last hour. And we know that the Antichrist is on the way. The red coats are coming. The Antichrist is coming. The false prophet is coming. Get out there and warn. Go tell the people. Go warn the people. It's time to get ready. It's time to take up arms and put on your armor. That we may stand. Hallelujah. To stand. And when you ain't got nothing else you can do, it's to stand. To stand on the word of God. Hallelujah. Having your breast covered with the breastplate of righteousness. Your head covered with the helmet of salvation. With your belt of truth. Your feet shod with the preparation of giving the gospel. Having your shield of faith and your sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Take up the armor of God. Prepare, 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 prepare. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand, brothers and sisters. Get right with God today. Get right. People say, what do you mean get right? Get right. God has sowed it in the heart of man and created man with a heart to know if they're right with God or not. Romans 8:16. His spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. All these people trying to justify themselves, asking all these questions. What about this? What about that? You already know in your heart. You already know in your heart what you're supposed to be doing. God, the Holy Spirit, brings conviction of sin. You already know it's sin. Why are you trying to justify yourself? Why do you keep asking? Go and do what you know to do is right. The Bible says if someone knows to do something right and they don't do it, it's sin. You know what's right. Stop asking and do. Repent. Go and do. All that the Lord has put in your heart to do, whether it be repent, whether it be to build orphanages, whether it be to build a church, whether it is to start a Bible study, whether it is to evangelize your neighbor, go and do all that the Lord has put in your heart, including repentance, including changing your wicked ways. I'll be back.